Like, one of the four times was this week. Tuesday. On Tuesday, I was flying back here from, I was in LA, and it was a long flight, 4 hours, four and a half, and I had, my friend gave me these gummy candies, and he was like, here you go, it's 25 milligrams of THC, which means that I can eat it and be a little high. That's all. It's like taking two shots. And then I opened up the package, and it looked like a Jolly Rancher, but then when I opened it up, it broke in half. And so I just looked at the two halves, and I was like, all right. And then I ate both of those. And then it turned out that it was two pieces. Not two halves of one. It was two pieces, so it was 50. So I was high as all fucking hell. Like, it was like one of the four highest times I've ever been in my life. And I was on an airplane. Oh, my God. Like, it had started to kick in when I was boarding, and then I sit in my seat, and I'm like, this is gonna be the best. Right? But then it just kept kicking in. It just kept coming. My bones got hot. My bones. Have you ever felt your bones get hot? No. My bones were hot, and it felt like it was coming from right here. It was just like all the way, like, right? Like, I started, like, I felt like I was buzzing, like I'd been plugged in. Like, oh. And I was still, at this point, I was still totally fine with it. A-okay. But in the past, I used to be real scared of flying. And I used to be real scared of being stoned in public and around people. And, you know, feeling trapped. Like, feeling like I can't leave. And an airplane is all of those things. Yeah, so as soon as I had the thought where I was like, I used to be scared of all of this, then I started thinking about why I was scared of it, and that's a terrible idea. Like, I was like, why were you ever afraid of flying? It's super easy. And then I remembered why, and I was like, yeah, what if we have to land on the Hudson River? And I was like, I won't know what to do. Like, I had a legitimate fear that we would land on the Hudson River, even though it's not in our flight path, even. Right? I'm going the wrong way. But I had a legitimate fear that I'd be this high, and then we'd have to land on the Hudson River, and then I would stand up and be like, what do I do? And everyone else would be like, you're fucking high. Why would they even think that? What are the odds I'm the only one that doesn't know what to do? Slim. I stopped moving. I was leaning against the window. My hood was up. My sunglasses were on. I was 100% convinced the guy sitting next to me knew I was high and was mad at me for it. Even though I wasn't doing anything or saying anything or moving, I wasn't even moving. There's a better chance he thought I was dead. Then I realized that, and I was like, this guy's not telling anybody. Like, this guy could think I'm dead, and he's not calling over a flight attendant or anything. Like, this guy doesn't care about me. And then I got sad. No, I'm kidding. I also had a thought where I was like, what if 9/11 happens again? What are you going to do? You're so high. I'm like, And then I finally realized, I don't know what to do in any of these situations if I'm not high. Like, I don't know what to do. We land on the Hudson River, stone cold sober. I'd still be like, which fucking wing, man? Which one do I go to? And then they'll be like, what are you high? And I'd be like, fuck you, man. It's the second time this has happened ever.